Are you a filmmaker,
producer, director?
My vision, my ideology into motion picture.
Actor, screenplay writer? Are you an aspiring filmmaker looking to start a career in the movie industry? Do you want to see what happens behind the scenes when you're looking at those movies in your local cinema? Take 101 will take you on a journey of the filmmaking process, from concept to reality, from idea to motion picture. Take 101 will bring you the industry professionals and take you through the A to Z of the filmmaking process.
Lucille Morgan on Take 101. Hello, welcome to Take 101. I'm Lucien Morgan. Today I'm at the Mayfair Hotel, looking very much forward to attending the Filmmakers Tea Party. In we go. Hi, and now I'm with Andrew Arthur. And Andrew, you were formerly a tutor at Harvard, is that right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, I lived in Boston for many years. I was a theater director and taught dramatic writing as a tutor at Harvard. And then I branched out into screenwriting and won awards, got an agent who said, you want to make movies? You got to move to L.A. So I moved to L.A. about 2 years ago, but I've been mainly here in London ever since because I'm working on a project about Winston Churchill's wife, Clementine Churchill, and a love affair she had while married to Winston with a younger man on the eve of World War II, whilst on an exotic cruise to Indonesia to bring back a Komodo dragon to the London Zoo. And that's all true.
Sounds an amazing story, and it's all true.
It is all true, and it could have changed history, because if she hadn't come back, Winston wouldn't have been prime minister. Without Winston, Britain wouldn't have stood alone, And without Britain, no D-Day.
Well, he wasn't the only politician that could deliver a speech.
It's true,
He did. He was so loved at the end of the war, he was voted out.
I know that story too.
That was a British appreciation. Mm-hmm. That was a British appreciation for him. It's strange how things can change history. Of course, Winston Churchill was knocked over by a car and nearly killed in New York.
Yes.
In the 30s.
Only saved by his fur coat.
Ah, you know the story. You know your history.
He looked the wrong way. So when I'm in London, I'm very careful to look at those signs. Look left, look right.
Is it a feature film, your...
Oh, yes, it's a feature. And we've got quite a bit of interest from financiers. They say it's going to be the next King's Speech. And I say, yes, please, give me the £10 million, and we'll make it the next King's Speech.
Hi, I'm now with Sades, and please tell me about your film. I've heard great things about it.
Thank you. Different is a true story. Different is a film based on a true story about a 14-year-old girl that was abducted from marriage and ended up killing the person who abducted her, and is stood trial for murder. And 2 years later, she was acquitted on the basis of self-defense and became the first woman at age of 16 to be acquitted on the basis of self-defense.
I see. Yeah. Great. And where did you film it?
Shot entirely in Ethiopia.
In Ethiopia entirely?
Yes. Yeah.
And it was an Ethiopian court?
Right. That's it. Yes. It takes place in Ethiopia. It's the, and yeah, so we filmed in Ethiopia. We... it's in Amharic, in the national language, and yeah.
Great, thank you very much for chatting to me.
You got it.
Thank you.
Are you a filmmaker, producer, director?
My vision, my ideology into motion picture.
Actor, screenplay writer? Are you an aspiring filmmaker looking to start a career in the movie industry? Do you want to see what happens behind the scenes when you're looking at those movies in your local cinema? Take 101 will take you on a journey of the filmmaking process from concept to reality, from idea to motion picture. Take 101 will bring you the industry professionals and take you through the A to Z of the filmmaking process.
Lucien Morgan on Take 101.
Quite similar to my previous film, Donkey Punch, in that it bridges a kind of territory between thriller and horror. And it's horror in the sense that it's got a lot of scares. It's about a student who elects to stay alone on her campus over Thanksgiving when the college empties, and then just by pure random chance runs across a bad group of people who just focus on her and decide to hunt her across this empty college campus.
Stay with me this one time.
You know my family. I have to go.
You can't stay there by yourself.
Mom, the flights are too expensive. I'll be fine till Christmas. It's weird, I've never seen it so dead here before.
Police in Oregon announced they found the 21-year-old's body on...
Help! There's people out there. And they followed me here.
I'm going out there.
No! 911, what's your emergency?
There are people trying to kill me. I need help.
We're already here, Christy.
Smile, Christy. Which is a horror, or a thriller for that matter, is that it's about an average person, like you, like me, like probably most of the people watching this, and it really just poses a very simple question, which is, you know, what would you do in extraordinary circumstances, but something that could easily happen? And I think that the mark of really great, certainly realistic horror films, you know, and thrillers is that question. It's all about normal human beings being put into ever more outlandish and more terrifying possibilities, you know, and that, you know, whether it's The Descent or whether it's, you know, Steven Spielberg's Duel, or, you know, even whether it's The Exorcist, it's always that question of you slowly start, you lay the trap and you slowly start to close it on people and go, this looks normal, now it's getting less normal, less normal, less normal, but you still keep identifying with it. And that's very much what I tried to do with this film. He's won many awards. This was a, it was a very well-known, very well-respected screenplay in Hollywood. It's beautifully written. Anthony wrote the screenplay kind of like, it's like reading a classic thriller book. It's got this very terse, very simple, but very well-constructed dialogue and sentences, and it does that thing of it just draws you in. And then what's really great, and actually the reason why I did this film, is that it is like Halloween, it is like The Strangers, it is one of these films where a woman is hounded, is put under ever increasing duress, but then I don't want to give too much away, but then as the film gets along, it does something that these films don't do, and it goes in a slightly different direction, which is quite exciting. It almost becomes more of an action thriller. I was a film journalist for a while. I worked for Sight and Sound and Premiere Magazine, some other places like that. For those of us who do it, you know, film is it's like falling in love with a cruel but wonderful mistress, and you just can't stay away from her. So I was just inextricably drawn to film, and I managed to get a place to film school in New York at NYU. I got a scholarship to go there, and I studied film there, which was a magnificent experience. And then I came back to London, and I started making a lot of music videos, a lot of commercials, and just learning that side of filmmaking. And then I also did a lot of writing. I've written scripts for other directors, people like Niels Arden Oplev, who made The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, and Fabrice de Weltz, who made Vignan, and just kept on, you know, discovering, you know, the more you do, whether it's directing or writing, whether it's music videos or commercials or TV, you're like a sponge and you absorb the knowledge. And you have to have perseverance. You have to really love what you do. And I think you do, because I think to make films, once you actually, if you are lucky enough to get out there and be on the set and be shooting, you know, that's tough. You often, you know, even if you're Ridley Scott, you often don't have enough time and enough money and enough resources to realise the vision you want to realise. So you have to, you know, you have to be resilient and strong all the way through. So I think that's important.
Are you a filmmaker, producer, director?
My vision, my ideology into motion picture.
Actor, screenplay writer? Are you an aspiring filmmaker looking to start a career in the movie industry? Do you want to see what happens behind the scenes when you're looking at those movies in your local cinema? Take 101 will take you on a journey of the filmmaking process, from concept to reality, from idea to motion picture. Take 101 will bring you, the industry professionals, and take you through the A to Z of the filmmaking process.
Lucien Morgan on Take 101.
Hey, this is Charles Chucky Venn, and you are now tuned in to Take 101.
How do you go about approaching reputable actors to help you make your movie?
I'm Pauline Long and you're watching Take 101.
Lancelot Oduwa Emason, I'm a Nollywood filmmaker. You're watching Take 101.
A beautiful evening tonight, and we are here at the very exclusive, very elite world premiere of Ortega and His Enemies, directed by the award-winning Malcolm Benson. Very exciting night tonight. Look at all the fabulous people over here, all the lovely little starlets. So stay tuned for this a very exciting evening on Take 101. One, we are at the fabulous world premiere of Ortega and His Enemies, and I am here with the very talented Mr. Lucien Morgan. Now, Lucien, can you tell us a little bit about what your role in this movie was?
Well, yes, I play a barrister, counsel for the prosecution, and that's quite fun.
Yeah.
And it was great fun doing that with Nettie playing counsel for the defence.
Right, and are you excited for this premiere?
Very, very much, yes.
Well, thank you so much for joining us, Lucien. I cannot wait to see you on screen.
Thank you.
Mwah. Hello, Gary.
Hello.
You're looking fabulous tonight.
Of course I am.
Welcome to the wonderful premiere. Now, can you tell Take 101 a bit about what your role in this movie was?
Well, yes, it's a kind of complicated role because I was an Irish ex-policeman who's an alcoholic, who's a cross-dresser.
Wow.
Who has a fling with his stepdaughter. Top that if you can.
That's an incredible character. Are you excited about seeing yourself on screen?
Well, I have seen it before, but I'm always excited seeing myself and can't believe it's the same person that's up there as me.
Well,
especially with hair.
I'm excited to see you on screen. It's all happening
well,
at the premiere
much.
Tonight. Thank you so much for joining us on
My
Take 101.
Okay.
I am standing here with the award-winning director, Malcolm Benson.
That's right.
Malcolm,
that's right.
How do you feel about your big night in this big movie premiere?
Very excited. It's been long coming, you know. You feel like the day is never going to come. But we are here now, and it's all happening in Genesis Cinema. So, two down, one more to go. That's in Lagos.
Fabulous. And you've got a really talented crew on board with you. How do you feel about how the actors have been in production with you?
Well, when you have 14 nominations so far for your feature film, surely is you give it down to your crew and your cast and the entire production. So I feel good. I feel that Ortega has really delivered, you know. Yeah, I'm very, very happy.
Well, there we have it from the man himself, 14 nominations. Now, you can't go wrong with that. This
yes.
is going to be an award-winning film.
He has already won 4 awards.
Well, look at that.
In fact, last 2 weeks, I won Best Director at the African Film and Academy Awards.
Wow.
Yes, and my 3 actors collectively have won Best Actor, Best Actress, Best Supporting Actor. So Ortega winning 4 awards is just really good.
Wow. Sounds like this movie is going to be a smash hit. So please, everybody, make sure you come and see this film. Ortega and His Enemies is where it's at.
That's what it is.
Sir, the CPS opposes the bail application made on behalf of Mr. John Ortega.
Mr. Ortega will be pleading not guilty.
Mr. Ortega, could you stand up?
Where is John? I don't need any explanation.
He's at it again.
Really? Yeah. You're in luck. I know someone that could use your services.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I've got news for you. Tell your management I'll see them in court.
That's just preposterous.
Oh, God, come on, not again.
I know where you live.
Are you a filmmaker, producer, director?
My vision, my ideology into motion picture.
Actor, screenplay writer? Are you an aspiring filmmaker? Looking to start a career in the movie industry? Do you want to see what happens behind the scenes when you're looking at those movies in your local cinema? Take 101 will take you on a journey of the filmmaking process, from concept to reality, from idea to motion picture. Take 101 will bring you the industry professionals and take you through the A to Z of the filmmaking process.
Lucien Morgan on Take 101.
Back at the premiere of Ortega and His Enemies, and I am here with the gorgeous, the talented, the beautiful Letty. Welcome.
Hi, hi.
So can you tell us a little bit about what your role in this movie was?
Just a lawyer, actually. I managed to get Ortega out of trouble, a little bit of trouble there, so being a nice British lawyer.
Are you excited to see how you fare on screen tonight?
Yes, I have seen it before, and okay. I thought I did pretty good. You tell me.
Well, I'm excited to see her on screen tonight. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank
you look absolutely
you.
Fabulous
Thank
tonight.
You. I love the pink.
Thank you.
I'm definitely excited. You can see that on my face. Thank you.
I can see it on your face.
Yeah, I don't want him to see that.
Well, you're looking absolutely fabulous tonight, Silva.
Thank you very much.
And as a director, being as talented as you are, we're excited that you're here with all of these talented directors and actors at the world premiere of Ortega and His Enemies.
Yeah, I'm very glad to be here supporting MA Benson. Yeah, he's a friend. He's been encouraging me as well. Now is the time to come around and, you know, be a part of what's happening here today. Yeah, I'm very happy to be here.
Fabulous.
It's happening here live.
It's tonight. Live, baby. It is live. Thank you so
tonight.
Much for joining us, Silva.
Thank you.
Hi there, and we would love to know who your fabulous self is and what your purpose is at this world premiere of Ortega and His Enemies.
I'm Danny Erskine. I'm a Nollywood Hollywood actor.
Okay.
I'm part promoting this film as well.
Wow.
With Mr. Benson.
Okay.
I've done about 10 Nollywood movies. I've done a few mainstream productions, Born Identity, EastEnders, and stuff. So I'm here tonight to support Mr. Benson.
Well, fabulous. Thank you so much for joining us, and thank you so much for helping in the production of this excellent premiere movie.
You're welcome. Yeah. Okay.
So are you excited to see what the film is all about this evening?
Absolutely. I've seen the trailer, and I'm hoping it's going to knock people's socks off.
Well, we are getting our socks knocked off by the way that you guys look tonight.
Get that dress. Look at that beautiful
look
dress.
At that dress. As you can tell, it is all happening tonight at the premiere. Beautiful people and for a beautiful film.
Can I compliment your dress as well?
Oh, thank you. Oh, you shouldn't have. Everybody's looking so charming. I'm so excited. It's such a fabulous evening tonight. Stay tuned. Hi there. We are here with the beautiful and talented Stephanie. Now, Stephanie, can you tell us a little bit about what your role in the film was?
My role was a cheese roll with ham in it. No, it wasn't actually. I play a police officer called Louise Taylor, and I try to arrest people, basically.
Wow, that sounds arresting.
Yeah, it does, very much.
Are you excited to see yourself on film?
Yeah, I am. We've already been to the Odeon with this already, so it's second time round now.
And what was your experience like working with the award-winning Malcolm Benson?
Really good, really good, yeah.
fabulous.
He's a brilliant director.
He is a brilliant director. We can't wait to see it. Well, thank you so much for joining us, Stephanie. We look forward to you arresting people on film.
Thanks.
We're getting up all nice and cozy with one of the fabulous and sexy actors in the world premiere of Ortega and His Enemies. What is your name, lovely sir?
My name's Dean.
Hello, Dean.
Dean Kerrigan.
Well, hello. And can you tell us what your role in the movie is?
Okay, so I'm I'm the bad guy.
Okay.
And I play a dodgy car salesman. Mm-hmm. And I am also, I'm kind of a rogue parking ticket enforcer as well.
Wow.
So I'm not very nice in the film, to be honest.
Okay, so you're one of the baddies, but tonight you look very nice, and tonight you seem really nice.
I hope I am nice. It's only a film.
Well, then you must be a really good actor to play the baddie.
You guys will tell when you see it.
Well, let's have a look and see how the film goes, but I think you are going to be superb.
Lovely.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, guys.
Are you a filmmaker? Producer? Director?
My vision, my ideology into motion picture.
Actor? Screenplay writer? Are you an aspiring filmmaker looking to start a career in the movie industry? Do you want to see what happens behind the scenes when you're looking at those movies in your local cinema? Take 101 will take you on a journey of the filmmaking process from concept to reality, from idea to motion picture. Take 101 will bring you the industry professionals and take you through the A to Z of the filmmaking process.
Lucien Morgan on Take 101.
Very talented actor that is starring in the world premiere of Ortega and His Enemies. Hi there, what's your name?
Theo Handen.
Oh, Theo, thank you so much for joining us. Can you tell us a little bit about what your role is in the movie?
Yep, I play Mr. Anuj Patel, I unfortunately suffer a loss, so I get very, very distraught and I go out trying to take some revenge as well. So there's a few scenes there of a bit of passion there, I could
passion.
Say.
Passion? Are you excited to see yourself on film?
Absolutely. It's wonderful to be on the big screen, so I'm very excited about the film. And like I said, Malcolm's a great director, so super excited to be in the project.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. So here we are with the very sexy Theo in person at the world premiere. This movie is going to be hot. Hi there, we are here with one of the very talented lead actors in the premiere of this fabulous short film. Hi there, what's your name and can you tell us a little bit about the premiere of the short film and what your role is?
Yeah, my name's Mo George. I'm the main lead role in Forget the Pact, which is a story about friends having a pact and then it all goes a bit not according to plan. So it's a bit of a triangle and it's a lot about friendship and betrayal. And there's so much packed in a short film. I thought it was brilliant when I first got the script that it had so much going on in such a short film, because it's hard when you're doing a short film to tell a full story. But Malcolm and his great work in the directions and the writers and the cast and crew made it come alive.
Fabulous.
Truth or dare?
Dare. No. Truth. Right. Between Lee and Sarah, who would you most like to get it on with?
Let's do it. Let's just make a pact.
But we have a pact.
He has a pact.
We had a pact.
Whose high heels do you want to find underneath your bed?
Yeah.
That was 9 months ago. Forget the pact.
Forget the pact, babe. We blame one exotic pepperoni. Hey, please, man, just get in the bath.
You so what have been lying to me. Get out! Pack it, then you go!
Thank you.
Are you a filmmaker, producer, director?
My vision, my ideology into motion picture.
Actor? Screenplay writer? Are you an aspiring filmmaker looking to start a career in the movie industry? Do you want to see what happens behind the scenes when you're looking at those movies in your local cinema? Take 101 will take you on a journey of the filmmaking process from concept to reality, from idea to motion picture. Take 101 will bring you the industry professionals and take you through the A to Z of the filmmaking process.
Lucien Morgan on Take 101.